streets is watching.
You are watching PM Live.
What's quacking, guys? Did you enjoy the carnival? You didn't go? Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot you don't have a life.
Streets is watching.
This is Last Week Today. We live in a country full of so much fake stuff. We've got fake politicians. Our markets are dumping sites for so much fake products, fake celebrities, fake chicks with fake hair and fake asses. Fake butt? Do you know how disappointing that is? But in the midst of all the fakeness, there's one thing we cannot allow to be fake. Money.
For long, the Ugandan market has been awash with counterfeit currencies, but with their source not established, despite numerous arrests of people suspected to be printing the fake money. This morning, the Uganda Police Force spokesperson Andrew Felix Kawesi revealed that they have established the source of the counterfeit money.
Apparently, all this counterfeit cash is being minted from Kenya, where we assume they have a fake Bank of Uganda.
The operation is on. We have already alerted our counterparts in Kenya. They have been very, very supportive.
We're all aware of how Kenyans love to make money. But come on, this is going a bit too far. How this counterfeit cash is getting into the country is not stated. Maybe they should question the money. You know, money talks. But apparently it doesn't snitch. So the moral of this story is, crime doesn't pay unless you make your own money and pay yourself.
Streets is watching.
So finally, I understand why Ugandan police are always so mad and violent and so angry all the time. They live really terrible lives. Last week on the news, we got a glimpse of the extremely harsh reality of the Ugandan policemen and women's livelihoods.
Such are the unpleasant houses that most of the lower-ranked police personnel and their families have been residing in. The houses, though dilapidated, accommodate a number of families.
I'm not saying corruption in any way is fine, but do you expect people living in these conditions to refuse a bribe? I mean, just look at this life. But all's not lost, because
this morning, the Inspector General of Police, together with the State Minister for Internal Affairs, Kanya Obiga, commissioned the construction of over 1,000 modern police housing units.
Unfortunately, Kaihura had a little something that didn't sit well with him.
Who have made the calculations, I think I've exaggerated. That each block, I will not mention the figure. But I don't agree with you.
Why he didn't state the inflated amount is still a mystery. I mean, is it a state secret?
We must go back to look at it and make sure that here we get value for money.
But I gotta give him props for wanting fairness in this project. Big ups, man. It's about time the Ugandan government did the police some justice.
Streets is watching.
Well, guys, that's all we have time for today. I'm Lens and I got the bounce. I'll catch you again next Monday with Last Week Today. Adios.
PM Live.